Hello, everybody. We'd like to welcome you to another Shiloh Pentecostal Sunday. Obviously, it's the Lord's Day that He has made, and we do want to rejoice and be glad in it. We're glad to have you with us, and we ask that, as always, that you stay tuned in for the message, and if there's any prayer requests you have or anything that you are in need of, please send us text through Facebook, and we will do everything we can to answer your prayers and to pray with you, and definitely to keep you in prayer. Brother
yes,
Terry?
Yes. Good morning. Good morning, Brother Chris, first and foremost.
Good morning.
I've already said good morning this time to you, but I want to say good morning again to and first to my church family this morning. You're adopted by Shiloh Pentecostal Holiness Church.
That's right.
I'm sorry, but that's just the way it is. We are attached to you. The yoke has been applied. And we're going to try and lead one another to become better workers and be the hands and feet of Jesus, Brother Chris, because that's what he wants us to do.
That's right.
Once we're touched and he lays his hands upon us, as I told Brother Nathan this morning, I said, he just retired. And I said, the Lord wanted him full time now so that he can go ahead and go to work and be his hands and feet. But good to see y'all this morning. The message is going to be, why is it more blessed to give than to receive? That's leading up to what I just said, because you get blessed in a manner that you cannot even describe when you're helping others, Brother Chris. And that's what I look forward to more than anything, is blessing those that need help. And we can let them know that we're just being our Father's hands and feet.
That's right.
He's the one that puts us in that place to be able to help. And I'm thrilled. Good to see y'all this morning. Let Brother Chris say a few words, and I'm going to look around and see if I can spot somebody to come and let you see them.
Yeah, we're going to find somebody to come over here. Like I said, we are glad to have you with us. We are always appreciative of any time you tune in and get a message. And, of course, we'd rather you be here if you're able. Obviously, if you're not able to physically come in, you know, the Lord has blessed us with technology, so you can watch it on iChurch and Facebook. And but we'd rather you be here, obviously. I mean, it's better for me, it's better to be here in person to interact with the brothers and sisters that are here, to interact with the pastor, to it's like going to a concert. You know, you can watch it on TV, but it's actually better to be live, you know, in person. The experience is totally different when you hear live. But Brother Terry, what's on your mind this morning?
Well, got a lot of things. This is a special service this morning. Pastor's sort of not letting it out yet on what's coming. So I encourage you to stay tuned, because it'll be a surprise for us as well as it's going to be for you. But next Sunday, I don't want to jump a Sunday. I don't want to miss a Sunday. But next Sunday, the 26th, bring a friend. I'm looking for a friend. I know Brother Chris is looking for a friend. The question is, are you going to be one of our friends next Sunday? We certainly love to see you come through those doors. But more importantly, you would be my friend. But wouldn't it be great if you'd be a friend of Jesus's next Sunday morning here at Shiloh? As that old gospel song, Brother Chris, what a friend we have in Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
Come and be his friend, and then you can be our friend as well. The golf tournament, October 16th, our Caring and Giving golf tournament. We raise that money. The church raises that money to give for those that are on hard times, or something has happened in the family that was unforeseen. Church doesn't keep any of this money. We provide it for those that are going through a tough situation, Brother Chris. If you get your friends, get with Brother Ricky Burfoot or get on and go to the app of Shiloh, and we'll get you that. We'll get you this application where four of you, three friends, sign up, and we'll get the form in where you can be one of the teams. We play down at Lakewood Country Club, October 16th. Food is provided for you. We just have a great time, a fellowship, and talking about the Lord as well. But don't forget, next Sunday as well, the 26th, is Bring a Friend. And then we have homecoming coming up October 3rd. So come and eat dinner with us. We'll cook for you. Come and be with us. We encourage you. We encourage you. Our church, time's running out. It's time for us to come together in fellowship. I'm going to still be looking for one more.
We definitely want you to be here. We definitely would love to have you with us and just be in the presence of the Lord, be in the house of God on a Sunday morning. I do understand, as a man who works 6 days a week, that sometimes, you know, if the only time you have off is Sunday, sometimes you want to take a trip somewhere and kind of clear your mind. I get that. Trust me, I get it. I might be planning me a beach trip here before summer's out anyway, just on a Sunday, just so I can kind of get away and kind of relax from the weekend. So we understand. We also understand that we're constantly being bombarded with the bad news that the news media and the government and all are trying to put a fear in us. Well, if your hope is in Christ, then there's nothing to fear. And he even said that, because he comes to give us life and life more abundantly. He is our hope. He is our refuge. He is everything that we need. He is greater than any of the bad that the world has to throw at us. And it's not to say that bad things don't happen, because obviously bad things do happen. But if he's walking with us, he is our comfort. He is our shield. He is our hope. He is our help. As Brother Terry continues to try to find somebody to come over here and put their face on this camera.
Brother Chris, I don't know.
They're being shy today. They're being shy today.
I want a head in mind there, and I wanted her to come up and speak a little bit. Good to see you there, brother. How you doing? Come here. What's your name?
I see some new faces.
Steve Dixon. Yep. Well,
how you doing?
I'm praying to see our church family. He walks in the door. He's family now, Brother Steve Dixon, and he's looking forward to seeing you in the house of worship. Amen. At Shiloh.
Good to see you,
brother, this morning. Brother Nathan, come here, stop. This is our singer here. This is our lead singer, the choir. He's all in one.
Yeah, he's the only guy with the neon shirt.
How y'all doing this morning?
All right. We got to wind it up. All right. Now you see, come and be with us. Turn around and come back and be seen on our church.
How are you doing?
So good to see you. We look forward to you staying with us on the service. Stay tuned at the end of the service where we can close it out. We want to wish y'all a blessed and glorious day. God bless you. Brother Chris?
We again, please stay tuned.
Yes.
Stay tuned for the message.
A lot of things in store, I believe.
Absolutely.
Today.
Yes, sir.
Maybe this is the day that the Lord is coming back.
That's a possibility.
Are you ready? Are you ready? That is the question.
That is a possibility.
Yes. We never can rest, Brother Chris, on we've got everything in line.
Right, right.
Yeah. We always need to double check. And God bless you. Are you double checking this morning? See you soon.
See you.
Good morning, Shiloh. Let's back up. Let's try that one more time. Good morning, Shiloh.
Good morning.
Oh, that sounds wonderful. Sounds wonderful. Just so glad that you come and be with us this morning, and just let you know how good you look out there this morning. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Do me a favor, okay? If you would, turn to your neighbor. Just turn around, turn to a neighbor, and tell them just so glad to see you this morning. Amen? Amen. 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 All right. All right. I hope everybody feels welcome this morning. Now let's do one more thing. Let's make our Lord and Savior welcome in his house this morning. Let's give him a hand clap of praise this morning. Amen. Amen. I think that just puts a smile on his face. Amen. So again, we just want to welcome each and every one of you. Just want you to know, as always, when you come through the door, you're family. Amen. Your family. You know, we don't have visitors here. When you come in, you're adopted. You're part of the family. So being that, we want each and every one of you just to make yourself at home as always and just feel free to worship the Lord as you if you feel led today. Amen. Amen. Know that we love you. And I want to welcome again everyone here, especially those out on the internet, iChurch. Want to make those especially welcome. And there may be some out in the parking lot too. So just thank you for coming, being a part of another Sunday at Shiloh. And just want you to know that we love you. So one last thing I want to ask you to do for me, and I'm going to turn it over to Brother Nathan, is turn to somebody and tell me you love them this morning. Love you. Amen. Love you too. Okay. All right. So let's make him welcome. We ask Nathan to come on at this time, and we'll just turn it over to him. So good to see you. God bless you. Glad you're here.
Everybody, let's stand to our feet this morning. Welcome in the Holy Spirit. If you've been walking the same old road for miles and miles, if you've been hearing the same old voice tell the same old lie, if you're trying to fill the same old holes inside, well, there's a better life, and there's a better life. If you've got pain, he's a pain taker. And if you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. We believe that this morning. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. And we've all run from things we know that just ain't right. Well, there's a better life, and there's a better life. You got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. You believe it, if you receive it, if you can't feel it, somebody testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can't feel it, somebody testify, testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, you can't feel it, somebody testify. You got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom or saving, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. Saving, he's a
Who believes that this morning, say amen. Give God praise this morning.
Amen. Is anybody in here this morning had any chains broken over your life? Amen. Anybody in this building today feel like you've been made free? Amen. Well, I have good news for you, and the good news is this. The Bible says, whom the Spirit sets free. Go on and say it again. Free indeed. Amen. Amen. I've been telling you, and I believe somebody's beginning to get it around here. I've been telling you, if you're still in bondage, get back in the altar. Amen. If you're still bound, amen, by the oppressions of the enemy, get back in the altar. Because Jesus said, I come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. And we're not waiting on the sweet by and by. Amen. I'm looking forward to that day when I can step from this life to the next. When I can give up this bed and move into that next bed that the Father has prepared for me. But guys, I want to tell you, I'm not waiting on the sweet by and by. The Bible said, this is the day that the Lord hath made, and I am to rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, amen. But we've not arrived yet. No, but I'm going that way, amen. And I don't know what that does for you, but it excites me today, amen. I'm looking forward to what God's got in store, amen. I just wish today I could open up my heart and you could see the joy that's leaping up and down inside of me, because this is a day that the enemy said, I'm going to lock down and I'm going to bind. But the Spirit of God said, hold on, I got one more move and I'm about to set somebody free. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now, I know some of you have been anticipating and waiting for the day because I've been trying to get you there. Amen. And I've had, I don't know, I guess 30 people walk in the door this morning and said, preacher, okay, I'm here. Tell me what the surprise is. Just hold on. It's going to be worth it. Amen. We're looking forward to a great day here in the presence of God. But before we do so, we want to welcome those that are joining us online. We want to welcome those that are joining us through our parking lot experience today as we broadcast into their radio. And we want to welcome you right here in the house of the Lord today. Amen. This is going to be a great day in the presence of God. Amen. So good to have you all here. It's always an honor to have guests with us, and we're really honored today to have Pastor Steve Dixon and his family with us today. And looking forward to, if you got a chance, go over to Brock's Chapel this week up out from Mount Olive. And he's going to be, y'all know this name, Doug Bartlett's going to be there with him this week. And but we're glad to have him here in Shiloh today. He walked in, he said, I want to come hear some good preaching. I said, oh, I didn't know you were preaching today. And we're glad to have them. We welcome you always. Our neighbors right down the road, Keith and them's neighbors, next door neighbors almost, and we're glad to have them. They're just family. I hope you heard what Brother Terry said when you walked in the door. You were not a visitor any longer. You're just part of the family. Amen. And I thank God for each one of you being here today. Amen. We got a lot going on around here, so we need God's touch and His anointing. Amen. Next Sunday is Friends Day. Amen. You remember? Our ladies are going to make sure you've got an invitation card when you leave from here. And I want you, just when you get that card, I want you to be reminded, this is not your card. All right? Darren's got it up front there for you to see, but I want you to be reminded, when you take this card today, it don't belong to you. Don't stick it in your Bible and carry it home. Put it on your safe. No, this card is a card that you're to be praying about this coming week. And you need to, I ask the Holy Spirit, who is that person of peace that you want me to invite to come and sit with me? Now listen, guys, we're not looking for somebody else's member. We're not looking for Aunt Susie that has a church home that we're going to invite and persuade to come and be with us one Sunday. That's not who we're looking. According to what I've been told by the page that the conference office supplies for us on any given Sunday within a 5-mile radius of Shiloh Pentecostal Holiness Church, there is over 1,500 people that are unchurched on any given Sunday. That's who we're looking for. We're looking for one more. But we're not looking for anybody else's. We're looking for somebody that's lost, somebody that needs Jesus, somebody that will come and sit with you on a Sunday that normally would not be in church. Amen. I just want to tell you, there's a little cue card there at the bottom, and if they will not come, just ask them, are you coming? Because if you come, I want you to bring this card with you. Amen. Because this card is going to represent a gift that they have an opportunity to win. But if they don't come, just ask them to click on that little link and join us through iChurch. Folks, we're looking for one more. We want to get them any way we can. Amen. Amen. I want to keep people out of hell. Amen. That's my job. Amen. And I believe you do too. Amen. 2 weeks from today is going to be homecoming. Amen. Homecoming right here in this building. We're looking forward to that. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise. Amen. Amen. So we want to get the unchurched here next Sunday, and then the following Sunday they can just come to homecoming. Amen. Wouldn't that be a great celebration? We are so thankful that you're here, and those at iChurch, those in the parking lot, but we're really thankful the Holy Spirit's in this room. We want to welcome His presence here today. But I also know that in the midst of all the joy that's running around in our hearts and in our minds, there's some hurting people around us today. There's some folks that need a miracle. There's some folks this morning that need a God to show up on the threshold of their heart and do a supernatural thing. He can do it, can you, Chris? He can do it. That's the God we serve. Somebody look at your neighbor and say, that's who I serve. He's able to do it this morning. If you've got a need or you are lifting a hand in representation of someone you know that has a need, just slip it up. Amen. Just hold it right there a moment. We're going to do it again this morning because I just feel compelled to do it. Turn your eyes to your own hand and think about the reason why you lifted it. Now I want you to begin to wave goodbye to it. And remember, when you bring it to Jesus, you can leave it there. Join me in prayer. Heavenly Father, I thank you this morning for what I believe you're doing right now in our midst. I invite you into homes and into offices and into automobiles that are joining us right now through a device on iChurch. We celebrate them today as part of our fellowship and part of our worship experience. God, they have needs this morning. We are interested in their needs. And we just invite them right there in that chat line to just type in those words, remember me. We're gonna connect with them, and we're going to pray with them, and we're going to believe God for them. But also, God, you saw every hand that went up in this room today. And today we're here not to contemplate all the need that is about us, but we're here today to focus on the great I am, the author and the finisher of my faith. The one who said, oh, hallelujah, there is nothing too hard for me. We bring our petition unto the Lord. We make them made known unto Him today. But we do it in great confidence because we are fully persuaded that the God we serve is able this morning, exceedingly abundantly, above all that I can think or imagine, according to your power, God, that is at work in us. Oh, yes, Lord, do it now. Do it right now. Oh, that I may know Him in the power of His resurrection and the fellowship of His suffering, being made conformable unto His death. God, I'm believing you for a miracle on behalf of hands that went up in this room today. Now, God, if we're going to pray, we need to believe. And if we're going to doubt, we need not pray. Now, God, I pray this morning in faith. In faith I have asked, and in faith I do believe. Therefore, in faith I know I will receive. Let it be done so in Jesus' name today. And the body of believers said amen and amen. Before you're seated, turn to that neighbor, throw up that hand. Let them know you love them. Let them know you're glad to see them in the presence of God this morning. Amen. And you may be seated this morning in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Before our young people come today and we allow them, this is going to be such a special service today. Ashley asked if our ministry team could remain in this morning, and our children are going to be a part of this because I think that's a great idea. Because this service today is going to be a very important aspect of our young people seeing and hearing and knowing. And this service today involves them as much as it does the adults. Some must say, God's good. Amen. This is a special day. This past week, Sister Vernell Brewington celebrated her 92nd birthday. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
Sister Vernell, if my memory serves me correct, is our oldest living member. And a few weeks ago, when Tammy and I were visiting her, she began to tell me something. And she said, Pastor, and some of you have heard me share this before, I feel like on that new bridge building, we need to have the words, because I've heard you echo it, a house of prayer. So this coming Tuesday morning at 8:30, they're going to be putting letters up on the side of this building. Amen. Shiloh Bridge, and on one end it will have House of Prayer. Amen. So at my last visit with her, she said, well, the Lord's visited me again. I mean, y'all know that's biblical. When we begin to walk it out, and begin to let this word prevail in our lives and hear what the Spirit is saying to the church and the body of Christ, God will begin to do some stuff. Amen. Somebody say, I need God to do some stuff. Amen. And God's doing it. So she said, God has moved on my heart to do something. And I'm going to share that here in just a few minutes at the beginning of our worship experience today for our message. It's going to be a special time. Somebody look at your neighbor and say, it's going to be special.
Yeah, it's going to be special.
Amen. It's already special. Amen. Before I turn it over to our young people this morning, I do want to remind you that D&D Gospels, Doing God's Work, is going to be having the Pouring Out Blessings ministry over today at the Botanical Gardens in Fayetteville, North Carolina. Yours truly is going to be the special MC for that service tonight. And there is a special gift and some gifts that are going to be going forth today. I told you you didn't want to miss the service today for some blessed people in this building. But the Ball Brothers will be there tonight coming to Fayetteville for the first time with their hit song, Old Church Choir. How about it, brother? Talk to me. Amen. And of course, some folks that are very familiar and loving to us, and that's the Oxendine family, are going to be there as well tonight. That is going to be a wonderful opportunity. If you don't have tickets, I think there may be some tickets still available. If you're interested in that, if you will see Phil, this is going to be a gala event. I'm understanding this is a linen cloth affair. It's going to be a wonderful China meal served there tonight. And I'm not sure I'm going to be in my comfort zone, but that's okay. Amen. So we're looking forward to a great time in the presence of God and looking forward to the outpouring of the Holy Spirit pouring out of God's blessings. The gates open there this afternoon at 3:30. The event starts at 4:30. The meal will be served. And then, of course, I'm not calling it entertainment. It's worship experience. Amen. Going to be taking place there tonight with the outpouring of God's blessings by the Ball Brothers and the Oxendine family. If you have an opportunity to go, please don't miss that. We invite our young people to come down. Let's make them welcome this morning. How many of you know the youth are the church of today? Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Bless them, Lord. Bless them. Let's give them another hand this morning. Amen. Oh, praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Good morning, guys. How are you? Good. Well, our lesson today is going to be about wishing, okay? Sometimes we make wish without thinking about what would happen if our wish really came true. Have you ever planned a birthday party or anything outside and it rained and you couldn't do what you wanted to do outside? That happens sometimes. And sometimes you may have to sit in and watch the rain, and you might even grumble to yourself, I wish it would stop raining. What if that wish came true and it really stopped raining forever? There would be no grass, no trees, no flowers. Rivers and lakes and streams would dry up, and all life would begin to disappear. This world would be a miserable place if it stopped raining, wouldn't it? James and John were two brothers who were disciples of Jesus. One day, the two of them came to Jesus and said to him, Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask. "What do you want me to do for you?" Jesus replied. "If you're in your glorious kingdom, we want to sit in places of honor next to you, one at your right and the other at your left." You see, they thought Jesus was going to set up an earthly kingdom, and they wanted to sit beside him on the throne. They wanted to share in his glory and greatness. But Jesus answered, "You don't know what you're asking." Then he explained that whoever wants to be great must be a servant of all. He said, "For even I, the Son of Man, came here not to be served, but to serve others, and to give my life as a ransom for many." I don't think that being a servant was exactly what James and John were wishing for. Sometimes you and I may say, "I wish I could be more like Jesus." But is that really our wish? If we really want that wish to come true, we must live a life as a servant, the way Jesus did. Only then can we be truly great and show God's love to the world. Right, let's bow our heads and close our eyes. Dear God, help us to mean it when we say, "I wish I could be more like Jesus." Please show us each day how to become a greater servant to those around us. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, we're going back to our seats today.
Who's thankful for the kids this morning? Amen. As this Christian walk that we go on, whoever painted the picture that when you become a Christian, everything's sunshine and rainbows, they lied to you. It's not. The reality of it is we all hurt, we all have pains, but the reality of it all is God's question is, do you trust me? Because at the end of the day, there's people that come up to you every day that are fighting real life battles that need an answer to their questions. I lost my daddy at 4 years old. I don't know why. I lost my brother when he was 18. I don't know why. And you want to ask yourself, why, God? Why did this happen? God has a plan for everything. I had a guy walk up to me at the shop Friday, and I can't give any details because it was in confidence, but he said, "Please remember me in prayer because I cannot understand why. I thought everything was great. God had said everything was good, but all of a sudden we've got another problem. But who knows that my Redeemer lives?" He lives today, the same God that was yesterday, the same God today, and the same God tomorrow. I pray this song will be a blessing to you this morning.
Told the sun where to stand in the morning, and who showed the ocean you can only come this far, and who showed the moon where to hide till evening, whose words alone can catch a falling star. Well, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. Let all creation testify. Let this life within me cry. I know my Redeemer lives. He lives. The very same God that spins things in orbit, he runs to the weary, the worn and the weak, and the same gentle hands that hold me when I'm broken, they conquer death to bring me victory. Well, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. Let all creation testify. Let this life within me cry. I know my Redeemer. He lives to take away my shame, and He lives forever. I proclaim that the payment for my sin was the precious life He gave. But now He's alive and there's an empty grave. Well, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. Let all creation testify. Let this life within me cry. I know my Redeemer lives. He lives. Oh, He lives. He lives. He lives. I know that.
How many of you know He lives? How many of y'all believe today that He lives for you? If you believe that, will you just stand to your feet this morning? I believe He lives for me today. Amen. I believe He lives for me today. Amen. We're about to enter into a very exciting moment this morning, because we're about to celebrate. See, a few weeks ago, I went and visited Sister Vernell, Tammy and I did, and she began to share with us what God had laid on her heart. And then the last time I went back to see her, she said, God has visited me again, and He spoke something that I need to do. And when she said it, I literally felt like I was blown back in my seat by the presence of God in that room. I've only felt that a couple of times in my life. I remember one time sitting in a lady's house visiting with her, and she's gone on to be with the Lord now. But when I got up to leave, she said, "Preacher, come here and sit down beside me." Sister Eloise began to whisper to me, and she said, "I had a visit last night from the Holy Spirit. And God's figure of His Son appeared at the foot of my bed. And He said for me to tell you something. He said to tell you to preach it. Preach it. Not a philosophy, not an idea, not a growth program. Preach it. The unfallible word of a true and living God." But she didn't stop. She said, "Preach it true and preach it strong." I felt blown back. When I visited with Sister Vernell the other day, and she said, "I had a visit from God," and she began to share with me what He had done. And she said, "God spoke to me and said, my birthday that I was to give a dollar for every year that I am old. And when she said that, I felt the Holy Ghost. His presence surreal in that room. You guys that have felt him, you know what I'm talking about when it feels like the air standing. And that's, you know, that's just such a foolish thing to say, but when you felt the presence of God and he's surreal on you, felt like the hair standing up on your arms, you knew he was right there. And so today we're launching something here in this building. It's a birthday celebration. Sister Vernell turned 92 years old this past week, our oldest living member. But we're launching today, and it will be moving forth as long as I am pastor here, the Vernell Brewington Birthday Celebration. And it'll be the Sunday following her birthday every year moving forward. And today, Sister Vernell is going to give her offering first. And then at the end of the service today, we're going to bring Sister Vernell down. We're going to celebrate her and God's gift to Shiloh Church through her. And not only her, but that generation of so many that have stepped off the stage into the presence of God. So many. My heart almost feels overwhelmed today when I think of them. But today we're launching the Vernell Brewington Birthday Celebration Offering. So what I'm asking you to do is participate. A few year or two ago, well, Jimmy, how long has your mom been passed now? 3 years, hard to believe. 3 years. I was at the Goldsboro Hospital 3 years ago. Brother Jimmy was back. They were getting ready to do a procedure on his mom, and I was sitting out in the waiting room by myself, and God began to have a conversation with me. And he asked me a question that offended me. God ever offended you? He's offended me quite often. He offended me to start with when he pointed out my sins. I felt offended. I felt ashamed. I felt broken and hurt. But God began to have a conversation with me, and he asked me a question. He said, "Are you a giver?" And I felt almost as the prophet of days gone by when he said, "Lord, you know I love you." I felt offended. I said, "God, you know I'm a giver." It almost felt insulting. But then God kept asking me and pressing me, "Are you a giver?" And he said, "Then why are you withholding from my people the gift to receive?" Because guys, I want to explain something to you about giving. Giving is never about what you're doing. It's about positioning yourself in a place where God can do for you. It's what giving is. Whether it's in your serving in the church, whether you're standing out in the parking lot in the heat, whether you're serving as an usher in the building, whether you serve on the platform or serve back in the booth, when you begin to serve, it's not about your time, your energy, your effort, your finances, your resources. It's about positioning yourself in a place where God can bless you. It's called the flow of the Father. Amen. You get out of the flow of the Father and you miss the blessing. Now, it's not God's will that any should perish, amen? God wants us all to receive, amen? So God began to deal with me that we needed to begin to teach and preach on tithing and giving, and I've done so out of great reverence. I remember calling the ministry director, and I said, "I'm doing a series next month on tithing and giving." They said, "You're doing what?" Because they knew my stance. I'd never preached on tithing and giving, and God challenged me there. And he said, "You're depriving the people of understanding the flow of the kingdom." So I come home, done a four-week series on tithing and giving. And you know what God did? God doubled our receiving. Is anybody listening to what I'm saying? Our tithing over doubled in the next 12 months. Somebody say, "That's God." And all during the pandemic last year, when many times we were having parking lot services and, you know, not being able to be here midweek, which we've never received a midweek offering at all, never. So if you want free service, come Wednesday night. It's free. It don't cost you anything. I mean, hey, a guy told me one time, "If it's free, it's for me." I said, "Come on." Amen. But it's about positioning yourself in a place where God can bless you. Okay? It's a special day. there's going to be some gifts in the room. Sister Burnell's already got some this morning, I saw, but others are going to receive gifts today as well. But right now, I want you to pray, and I want you to ask God. This is not a prayer that you need to pray for your neighbor. You need to pray for yourself. You need to say, God, I'm opening my heart in this room today, and I'm going to let you do something in me. I don't know what God wants to do in you. It may not have anything to do with giving and receiving. It may be a gift that God has prepared for you today for salvation. Guys, I want to tell you, if you're in this building today and you're lost, you need Jesus. I'm just telling you today, you need Jesus. There's no greater need in this present life than Jesus Christ. He's the author and the finisher of your faith. He loves you today supremely. Amen? He loves you today. And I want to tell you something. You can't out-sin God. I'm just telling you, you're not a better sinner than Jesus is a Savior. Some people would say, well, preacher, you don't know what I've done. No, you don't know what my Jesus did in a place called Calvary. He went above and beyond. He went beyond anything that you could think or imagine. Oh, you don't know us guys from back in the days. No, you don't know my Jesus from 2,000 years ago. That's what you don't know. And here's the good news. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He loves you this morning. How can God love somebody like me? I don't know. I really don't know how He can love me, but He loves me. He loves me today, and He loves you. Would you join me in prayer? Heavenly Father, right now as we stand in this place, God, we give you access to our hearts this morning. I am believing you today, God, not for what we need, but what your people need today. And I'm asking you this morning to do that only you can do. We open our hearts and we surrender them to you. And I believe today, God, you're going to do something amazing. I believe you're going to do something miraculous in this building today for somebody today. I believe you're going to open the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing on somebody today that they're not even prepared to receive. Abundant blessing. Overflow blessing. Thank you, God, now for what you're about to do in my heart. Can you just say that with me today? Thank you, God, for what you're about to do in my heart. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord today. Amen. Amen. Why is it more blessed to give than to receive? You see, his Lord said unto him, well done. This is Matthew chapter 25 and verse 23. His Lord said unto him, well done. Did you hear that? How many of you know, and how many of you believe that one day every one of us are going to stand in the presence of a true and living God? It doesn't matter whether you believe it or not, it's going to happen. Amen. So I read a bumper sticker. You know, bumper stickers used to be something pretty famous years ago. You don't see many people putting bumper stickers on their cars anymore. Most cars don't even have bumpers. They just got plastic. Yeah. But a bumper sticker said, I read God's word. I believed it. And that settled it. When I first read that, I said, I like that. That's pretty good. And then I got to talking about it. And I said, no, that's just contrary to God's word. Guys, I want you to know that when God spoke His word, that settled it. It don't really matter whether you and I believe it or not. It was already settled. Amen. 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 You know what God said? He said, let yea be yea and nay be nay. Amen. And I'm just here to share with you this morning, right out of God's word this morning, and I just want us to get this together today. The Bible said, His Lord said unto him, well done. I mean, you know there's going to be a reality to that to those of us that do well. So as your shepherd and as your pastor, I want to help you find that place and that rhythm in the Holy Spirit to be able to do well. His Lord said unto him, well done, good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things. That really really caught my attention this week when I read that verse again, because I don't know how, but for some reason I just always kind of pictured in my mind, maybe it was because of my background and my history of growing up in the church, but I just kind of always felt like that, Brother Nathan, that I had to get it all right, that I had to be 100% on spot on everything. We were even taught in my household where I grew up that when we got up on Sunday morning that we put on, and don't, please don't take this disrespectfully, we put on our holy garb and we got to looking our very best and we got ready to go to worship. How many of y'all know that our life is a worship experience? Amen. God even says, as you do unto others, you do it also unto me. And God said, whatever you do, do it as unto me. Worshiping God is not something we put on and do. Amen. Even though we call this a worship experience, our life is a worship to Almighty God. But I just kind of always felt like that I had to get it all right. I had to figure out how I was going to serve God in such a way that one day I would stand in the presence of Almighty God, a wretched sinner, lost and undone without hope, and the saving grace of God was going to come into my heart and my life and create an atmosphere where one day I would be able to stand in the presence of God, Him breathe on me. How many of y'all know God will kill you? If y'all don't know God will kill you, go read the Old Testament. Amen. Me stand in the breath of Almighty God, this God that just killed people because they offered to do something and then didn't do it. Amen. But then I read the Word of God again, afresh and anew. And I heard Him say, His Lord said unto him, well done, good and faithful servant. Then He said these words, thou hast been faithful over a few things. Man, I found some hope right then. Amen? I found some real hope right there, because I began to realize that God has equipped me for this journey that is called life. And even though I don't get it all right, I'm not dead on spot, perfect in every situation. Even though I find spots and blemishes in my life, imperfections and shortcomings and failures, God said, hey, I'm going to honor your faithfulness in a few things. Amen. Come on, guys, let's get over church a minute and let's get in the presence of a true and living God who is able to do in my life exceedingly and abundantly above and beyond that I can even think or imagine. Not because some preacher said so, not because some denomination said so, not because some church said so, but because God's Word says so. Amen. How is all that maneuvering and working in me? I'm glad you asked. God said, according, somebody say, according to my spirit that is at work in you. Somebody say, He's still working on me. My only requirement is to just be faithful in a few things. You know what that means? Whatever I can be faithful in, do it. Amen. 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 Just be faithful in a few things. And then, oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. Now here it is. He said, I will put you in charge of many things. Woo, hallelujah. If I can just get faithful. Now, guys, I want to tell you something. God ain't going to do it all for you. You know what God will do for you? What you can't do. Hello? But what you can do, God expects you to do. And if you'll get faithful in what you can do, God will pick up the slack in what you can't do. I'm preaching. And He's going to provide an intercessory by the name of Jesus Christ. He identifies Him as a spotless lamb. And then the Lord shows up and says something like this, not by might nor by power, but by my Spirit. And I recognize that Spirit that is at work in me is the identifying factor that's going to place me in the presence and the breath of Almighty God. And I'm going to be able to hear Him say, "Well done, thy good and faithful servant." Amen. My qualification is to get faithful in the stuff that I can do. Amen? And if I'll do what I can do, God will fill in the gap on the back end, and He'll put a spotless lamb between me and the breath of God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. He said, "I'm going to make you ruler over many things. Enter thou into the joy of the Lord." I don't believe God is a past tense God. I don't believe God is a future God. I believe God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. I believe the God I'm serving today, those that served Him decades ago, was serving the same God I'm serving today. Amen? And I believe the God that we're serving today is going to be the same God that the future generations, these little ones, are going to be serving, amen, when they arrive on their platform, amen, until the Lord comes. He said, "I am God and I cannot lie." And what He said was, "I am the same," amen, amen. What He's done for past generations, present generations, He's going to do for future generations, amen. And when we get faithful in the few things that God has assigned us to do, God will begin to show us glory. Oh, hallelujah. There's too many of us sitting on the sideline waiting for someday out yonder in the sweet by and by when we're going to be reunited with mama gone yesterday and daddy gone the day before. Honey, I want to tell you, Jesus said, "This is the day that the Lord hath made. Rise up and rejoice and be glad in it." Amen. I'm not waiting on God's kingdom. God's kingdom is already here. I just need to rise up and get faithful in a few things. And if I begin to get faithful in my little bit, God will add to me what I don't have. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Is anybody listening to me this morning? Can I just go on and be real this morning, Sister Rita? Do I have your permission? Amen. I remember pastoring here 12 years ago and thinking to myself, "Lord, I'd give anything in the world if we could have $1,500 in tithe." Sister Rita sent my wife, because she don't send it to me, she sent my wife a message this week, and she said the tithes and offerings last week was over $8,000. Dollars. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise. It ain't about dollars and cents. My Father owns the cattle on 1,000 hills, amen. If I got need of something, the Bible declares, He'll get rid of one of them cows if He's got to. I believe that. He said, "I'll supply all of your need according to my riches in glory," amen. He ain't got to come sell your cow. He can sell one of His. Amen. Amen. Because it don't belong to you no how. Look at your neighbor and say, "It ain't mine no how." I'm trying to position you in a place, amen, where you can understand the principles of God and allow God to begin to operate and flow in your life. Amen. His master replied, "Well done, good and faithful servant." Amen. We preach this verse of Scripture at every funeral that's ever been had. Praise God, they finally got in the presence of Almighty God. Hogwash. Do this right here. You're in God's presence. Amen. Did you hear me? The Bible said He breathed the breath into your nostrils. When you inhale, you bring in God. It's time for the church to recognize what we're bringing in and understand when we exhale, we need to be putting back out God. Amen. Amen. His master replied, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You've been faithful in a few things." Guys, it dawned on me right in the middle of this text when the Holy Spirit showed up, because I ain't got enough sense to see it. But before I opened the book, this is what I said. I prayed it like I have every time before. Father, show unto me great and mighty things that I do not yet know. Amen. He'll do it. And right in the middle of Matthew 25 and verse 23, I realize he won't talk to the dead. His master replied, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You've been faithful with a few things. I'm going to put you in charge of many things." We stand up here and we preach and we teach that we got the keys to the kingdom. Vehicles don't even have keys no more. Lord, I ain't even my key on there. I got the keys to the kingdom. There they are. We stand up here and preach it and teach it, but we're waiting on the great, sweet by and by, someday out yonder in the near future, when the church is going to rise again. Oh, I would that I could sing. I'd sing it right now. I want to ride. Amen. I want to ride with Him today. Amen. I don't want to wait till tomorrow. And I believe that if I get faithful today in a few things, in what I can do, the God that I serve is going to show up and He's going to put me in charge of many things. Amen? Amen. And then He said, here's how I know He's talking to the living, because He said, come and share your master's happiness. And then I heard the Spirit of the Lord said, this is the day that the Lord hath made, and what? Rejoice and be glad in it. Honey, I just got to tell you, if we'll get the stuff right that we can get right, God is going to make us ruler over things that don't even belong to us. Oh, hallelujah, you ain't hearing me. God is going to supply your riches, your need according to His riches and glory. He'll give you the desires of your heart. Amen. Amen. Somebody say it don't belong to the world. They don't have the power to take it away. And they don't have the power to give it. Sister Vernell went out for a day of shopping. Vanessa and them heard they were going to put the place on lockdown, took her and run. Amen. I told Tammy, I said, I bet that was a breakout at Spirits right there. Bless her heart. Sister Vernell didn't even know it yet, but they were beginning to celebrate. Man, we're free, free, free at last. Amen. She come back to that home that evening and they had put her on lockdown. That was 2 weeks ago. And my heart right in here, Sue, it says, phew. Because I knew this day and I knew the plans we had. And I told God last week, I said, God, that woman's been faithful in what she's had control over. I couldn't share it. Wednesday night, I was so happy because when I walked in that door, I got a text from Vanessa. And it said, Sunday. Somebody say, Sunday. The home is going to come out from under lockdown. And Mom's going to be able to be in the building. You know what God said? God said, I'll put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness. Amen. Woo! He's real, church. He's real. He's real. Hallelujah. My Lord, have mercy. Help me, God. As Paul planned to sail to Jerusalem, he met with the elders of the church at Ephesus, saying farewell and encouraging them in their work in the Lord. He reminded them of his labor among them over a 3-year period and called on them to give their labor as well. In everything I did, he said, I showed you that by this kind of hard work, we must help the weak. remembering the words the Lord Jesus himself said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. Amen. And I thought back what God had done when this church, somebody say this church, began to position itself in a place where God could bless the church. You know what you did? You began to prefer those that were less fortunate than you. You begin to say, why don't we bring in through our caring and giving ministry tithe into the storehouse that can be meat to the kingdom. And all of a sudden, light bills are being paid. Groceries are being put on tables. Ramps are going up for people that can't get in and out of their houses. One house that was in foreclosure was saved. Somebody say, God is... Amen. When we begin to position ourselves and do what we can do, God will do the rest. Ricky Barefoot. Amen. 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 All I got to do is just be faithful in the little bit that I can do, and God will fill in the gap and will do the rest. As the pastor, you're standing here thinking, well, God, if we give away $20,000 this year, what's going to happen to the budget of the church? And God says, watch this. Because I'm able to do exceedingly and abundantly. Hallelujah. I'm talking about getting you positioned in a place where God can bless you. Amen. You've heard me say it probably a dozen times in 12 years, I don't need your money. I don't need your money. I love you. I respect you. I honor you. The faithfulness of people like you have given us the opportunity to be able to propel the gospel literally around the world right now, this day. Amen? But guys, it ain't about you. Don't you ever think, well, if I quit giving, that place will shut down. Don't you ever put yourself up for that fall. I want you to understand something. God has a plan and a program over your life. And all He's wanting you to do is catch the vision so He can bless you. Amen. And if you'll become faithful in what you can do, God will fill in the gap. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. You're not likely to go wrong here if you keep remembering that our Master said, you're far happier giving than getting. That's the way the message said it. I kind of like that. And then NIV says it like this, and everything I did, I showed you that by this kind of hard work, we must help the weak, remembering the words of the Lord Jesus Himself when He said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. Amen. So why are you preaching this now, preacher? I'm glad you asked. Because Proverbs 22 and verse 6 said something like this right here. Start children off on the way that they should go, and even when they're old, they will not turn from it. You see, guys, we're just laying up memorials here. So when the next generation, when I get there, I told one of these ladies this morning, I said, you know that older generation is getting younger all the time. Amen? But I don't need your rocking chair. Amen? Amen? And how many of y'all know that Sister Burnell don't need your rocking chair? Because God's still speaking. She's still hearing. And she's becoming faithful in what she can do. I like what she told me. She said she asked Vanessa, she said, do you think I can do that? She said, why, sure, Mom, you can do that. Amen? See, that's the way it is sometimes. God, can I really do that? Amen? But when you get faithful in what God is asking you to do, because how many of y'all know God won't never ask you to do something you can't do? Now, He's going to ask you to do something that's not in your ability to do it. Did you hear me? But whatever He asks you to do, He's going to make a way to do it. Because I got so many things on the budgets now that every time I start towards Brother Linwood, he's looking at me like, what now, Pastor? What now, Pastor? So when Sister Murnell said, we need to put some letters on the side of that building signifying what the building is and what it is all about, that we are now a house of prayer. Amen? First thought, Chris, that popped in my mind, well, how am I going to pay for that? So then I thought about you, Chris. I'm just playing. That was the pizza talking. It wasn't the Holy Spirit. Amen. Not unless God tells you. I mean, I'm just saying this. Who am I to stand in the way of what God says? Amen. Okay. Now I'm back over here acting like I got some sense a little bit. So when I went back, she said, God's visited me. And he told me to give a dollar for every year. And I thought, that's $92. And then all of a sudden it dawned on me, I just turned 60. And I said, that's $60. And then my wife is 58. Are you hearing me? And then I pulled up in the yard one day and got a piece of mail out of the mailbox. Let me lay that one out there because that's me and Tammy. I'm never going to ask you to do something I'm not going to do. And Sister Vernell's going to be placing this and also in the back basket today because this is Ricky and Donna, which is, most of us know him as Pastor Ricky. Sister Vernell's son that pastors in Alabama, and he sent a check for his birthday. Somebody say, God, get out of the way and let God do it. Amen. I just got to get faithful in what I can do. You know what I could do? Write my check. Position myself in a place where God could bless me. This ain't about your money. My Lord, I used to hear preachers stand up and say, if you'll send me $50, I'm going to pray for you. Honey, I'm going to pray for you if you don't never put another penny in the plate. Amen. Amen. The gospel is not for sale. I evangelized for 15 years, went all over this state and part of a couple of more states. I never was in need. I left home one night and didn't have enough money in my pocket to get back home on. I said, God, I'm going. I had enough gas to get there. You remember it, baby? We got there that night and I prayed and I said, God, you said you supply all of my need. We went through the whole church. They didn't give me a dime. That's the reason why Mike Mills, you can ask him, when he shows up here on Sunday night, first thing I do, brother, are you okay to get back and forth this week, or do you need a little blessing to start this thing off? I didn't have enough money to get home. I'm sitting in my car. The parking lot has just emptied, and I'm sitting there thinking, God, I don't know what you're doing, but I don't like it. And about that time, it was dark. About that time, I seen two headlights are coming. Old man pulled up. Remember him, baby? Old man pulled up, got out of the car, and he said, I'm old and I almost forgot. God spoke to me and told me to give you this piece of money before I left tonight, and it slipped my mind. Somebody say, the Holy Ghost will remind you. You know what he said? He said, I'll supply all your need according to my riches and glory. He didn't just start then. He started way back yonder when I got faithful in a little bit of stuff. Can I just tell you, I wasn't faithful in very much. I ain't even sure I was saved. I'm real sure I wasn't sanctified. Beyond a shadow of a doubt, I wasn't sanctified. Absolutely was not sanctified. But I had a fear of God because I had a daddy that said, son, when I got that first paycheck, he said, you need to lay your tithes aside. He said, because you might steal from man. And I thought, now who has told him I've stole from him? And because he's fixing to kill me. And he said, but you don't want to steal from God. He said, and every penny you make, if you'll pay your tithes on it, God will bless you. You know what he did, Pastor? He set up a memorial that taught me something. Even when I ain't sure I was saved and I knew I wasn't sanctified, I was far from living right, but I got one thing right. I paid my tithes. And what it did was position me in a place where God could bless my future. Amen. I don't need your money. This ain't about your money. It's about moving you to a place where God can bless you. Amen. My Lord, have mercy. Somebody say, pray for that preacher. Start your children off on the way that they should go. Train up your child in the way they should go. Point your kids in the right direction. Why is it more blessed to give than to receive? Knowing the why often helps us follow through with the what. First, somebody say, he's just on number one. First, giving the blessings are gifts which come directly from God. God is a giver. When we give, we are blessed like Him. Therefore, as we give for the needs of others, we are blessed to serve and provide in the same way we receive from the Lord. Secondly, when we give, we open the door to more blessings from God. Like all parents, God wants to see His children being kind, generous, and loving. When He finds us doing those things, He encourages us to do more of those things by blessing us as we do them. Amen? Thirdly, when we give, we experience a unique closeness with God that can only come to us as we are generous and kind to others. As we give, we open the door to that wonderful closeness with Him. And finally, our giving means we have already been blessed. Amen? We don't have to be the recipient who needs. We can be blessed who is able to give. Amen. Just so you'll have something to ponder and I'll feel better. After the Vietnam War, a small city wanted to place a memorial in the city center. Solicitors went door to door asking for donations. At one house, the volunteer asking for contributions told a husband and wife of a family down the street who gave $5,000 in memory of their son killed in Vietnam. The wife squeezed her husband's hands and said, "Let's give $5,000 as well." The husband replied, "But we didn't have a son killed in the war." Don't that sound like daddy logic? She then looked at him and said, "Let's give because we didn't lose our son." It is more blessed to give than to receive. Keith, would you bring Sister Vernell down? I told you this is going to be a unique service today. And right here's the part where I normally give the altar call. And we invite you to have a need met. Well, this altar call today is going to look very different than one that you may have been in previously. Because today, we're giving an altar call to put legs on your prayers. Boy, it got quiet then, didn't it? It's a beautiful day. Sister Vernell wanted to give her money today for her birthday gift. Now, I want to explain something to you that not everybody in this room is able today to give a dollar for every year you've been alive. There are probably some kids in this room today that don't have a dollar for every year they've been alive. There comes a time when you got to step up and say to your child, We're setting a memorial here. We want you to understand something. You're positioning yourself in a place where God can bless your future. So some of you may not have been prepared to give. I know only a handful of you even knew we were going to receive an offering today. But this is the Vernell Brewington birthday celebration offering because God spoke it into her. And the first thing we're going to do with this offering is we're going to pay for those letters that are going on the side of the building because God gave her a vision. And so God said, okay, here's the way you're going to pay for it. But I believe that it's going to supersede that amount. And I believe then we're going to, there it is, there's the picture, that's what it's going to look like. And then we'll take the remainder of that and we'll put it in the building fund, if that's permissible with you, to keep on with the projects that are moving forward. But I want to give Sister Vernell the opportunity. Is there anything you'd like to say this morning, Sister Vernell?
I just thank the Lord that I'm here and that He blessed me to be 92 years
Amen. I'm going to let Sister Vernell put her offering in this bag. I'm going to let you put Ricky's offering in that bag. And I'm going to let you put Pastor Eddie and Sister Tammy's offering in that bag. And I know some of you were not prepared to give this morning. I'm not asking you to give a dollar. I'm asking you to give what God puts on your heart to give. Because God may tell you to give $1,000. God may tell you to give 50 cents. Whatever you can do, you do. Now, some of you would say, well, I would like to give, but I don't have to give. So Fred Maynard from Godwin, North Carolina, is going to be standing up at this time. We're going to give you a moment. But if you'd like to have a pledge card, which is just an index card that's blank, and says, I promise to give my birthday offering. Will you hold up your hand? And Fred's going to come. Him and these guys are going to come and make sure you all got cards. This will take just a moment, but how many of y'all know, say, it's worth it? And it's not about what the church is going to receive. It's what you're going to do right now by positioning yourself in a place to give. Vanessa and Larry, I'd like to invite y'all, if y'all will, to come and stand beside your mama Keith. Will you come today and stand with her? I want to ask the extended family to come, because if I do, then all of us are going to come, because we all feel like she's ours. If you'd like to give, and in giving today, it's going to be designated for this specific offering. I want you to be able to do so. So if you're not prepared this morning, but you need that index card, just slip up your hand. One of these, Shannon or Fred, will get that to you. I want you to give. And I want you to train your children to give. Shannon, there's one behind you back there, brother. I want you to help your kids understand the reason why you're doing this. Guys, I want to tell you something. God is an amazing God. Hey, Nathan, will you look at that sign out front, out there, and tell me the exact words it says on it in front of the church? No, the sign, the marquee out front that's got the letters on it. There's a sign out there, unless somebody stole it, it's in church called. Because I read it. Hey, you guys been watching that sign? Yes, ma'am. Let go, give it to God. Now, I want you to tell y'all how God works. I've been wrestling with this thing now for about 3 weeks since she told me. Anita puts that sign up. Anita didn't know what this service was about today. She is in the mountains seeing her daughter at college up there this weekend. But this week she came and was faithful in the little thing that she could do for today's service. She don't know how important that was, that she was obedient in the little thing. Because I got up this morning, Pastor Steve, you don't know what I'm talking about. Chris, you're going to know what I'm talking about. Sister Lydia, you're going to know what I'm talking about. And all the way over here, the devil, boy, he's just pounding me. Man, you sure you're going to do this today? Have you lost your ever-loving mind? And when I pulled up, I saw that sign. She didn't have a clue. God wants to position you in a place where He can bless you. Will you stand to your feet? Father, I thank You, Lord, today. I thank You, Lord, today for envisioning. I thank You for the faithfulness of this dear child of God. So many would say when you reach a certain age that you no longer have value, that is a lie of the devil. Because I believe that You're still speaking to all Your children. regardless of how young or regardless of their age. You're just speaking to people that will have ears to hear what the Spirit is saying. And I thank you for using Sister Vernell in this special way to help position this body of believers in setting up a memorial here at this church, that in years coming, that young men and young women and small babies will be positioned in a flow that God can pour out. It's called getting in the vein. And I thank you for it, Lord. Thank you today for your children. You nurses can help me here, but when you're about to draw the life-giving source, blood, you got to get in the vein where the blood is flowing. Now, church, I just want to tell you today, the only way you're going to get in the flow of the blessings of God, you got to get in the vein where God is operating out of. Don't be mad with me next week if you are not faithful in a little, if you've not positioned yourself in a place where God can bless you. Because there's an enemy, and he's coming to kill, steal, and destroy. But Jesus said, but I come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. This is the altar call. Come and get in the flow. Would you do so this morning? I'm going to let Sister Vernell just hold that basket, that bag, and we're going to receive the offering, the gift there. As God moves on your spirit, you just come and give. Some of you just need to be praying and talking to God. Now, God, you know I'm giving out of my need, but I'm believing you this morning. I'm plugging into that vein of flow, and I'm trusting you today, God. I am fully persuaded, God, that you are able. It's not by might nor by power, but it's by your Spirit. Going to wait till the last Sunday to put this blessing bead in the jar. We're going to do it today. I just want you guys to go ahead and put your thanksgiving, because this is a God thing, in that jar.
Pastor Eddie was going to hand me a bead. But last year during the lockdown and when most of us were home, I was watching online church, and the first of the year he said, "I want everyone to take home a bag of beads." I said, "Well, I don't have a bag of beads." And I thought about Mom was locked down. I couldn't get a bag of beads to her. I said, "It would be so wonderful if we could at least one time be able to put our bead in that jar," and he didn't know. But I'm just so thankful and so overwhelmed today, because God is so good.
Hey, man, you guys can be seated if you'd like. I have a, we're fixing to go. God works in strange and mysterious ways. I hadn't said a lot about it because this was just something I was asked to do this afternoon, to MC this thing. The reason why I didn't mention it, because it's a fundraising event. When I found out what it was about, because I'm very reluctant, you know, to be involved in something like that, but I found out they were feeding the homeless, and I thought, man, wow, that's right up our alley. I'll do it. Didn't have any idea what the event was going to be about, and when I found out, you know, that it was, you know, kind of a upscale event, I thought to myself, "Oh Lord, what are you up to now?" And so anyhow, when I saw the price on the tickets, I almost felt like, man, I just wish I wasn't even involved in that. How many of y'all know it costs money to be a blessing? These tickets are $80 a piece. That covers the sing, and it covers the, what do you call it, crystal plate meal? China plate meal. I don't even know how to talk about this stuff. But Phil has so graciously blessed his pastor today with 6 tickets that I would like to give today on behalf of Sister Burnell Brewington. Today, would Sister Burnell be able to go today to the scene? And no pressure. If she's not able to go, I understand. Let her go. All right. How many of you are going with her? Would y'all be able to go? I don't want to just give these tickets away if you're not going to be able to use them. So if you can't use them, you know, I'd rather not give them. Okay. All right. All right. I have 4 tickets left. I told you you were going to be blessed. Can you go? Sure. I have 2 left. Who would like them? She wants one. I have 1 left. Okay. Give these away. And she's got hers. We already got hers. Does anybody else be able to go? I got a couple of tickets left if anybody else will be able to go. All right. There they are. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise. Brother Limmer, if you will come, Sister Rita, I will get this in your hands. Somebody say, God is good.
God is good.
Amen. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Pastor, for that word today. Give God praise in the house today. Amen. God's good, ain't he? I probably told you before, but Sister Burnell, she's a real special lady to me. because in 1981, over in the old church, Sister Vernell, Liberta Emanuel, and Miss Eva Chance, there was the Shiloh Trio, amen. And they were singing that day, and I give my heart to the Lord on that Sunday morning. And that's the reason she's so special to me. And I've been serving the Lord ever since 1981 and been coming to this church and serving God. Amen. That lady right there is inspiration to a lot of people. I've been in her home and eaten many a meal with her. I've watched a few ball games too, ain't Sister Vernell? Amen. Pull for UNC. Amen. Some of them pull for state, but some of them pull for Carolina. Amen. But she's special today, and I'm so glad today that we was able to honor her, because we should do that. Amen, church? Yeah. Honor those that have paved the way for us today. We thank God for Sister Vernell. We also thank God for those who are not with us to hear. They're gone on, but amen. They were a big part of it too, but I give God and praise for that. Just thank you for coming today. We pray that you have been blessed today. I know the word of God has touched our hearts today. Amen. Let's give unto the Lord. If we give unto the Lord and we do our part, He's promised us that He's going to bless us. Amen. And we truly are a blessed church today. We are truly a blessed people. God, let's stand this time. We're going to close in prayer today. But I just thank each and every one of you for coming today and being a part of our service today. We just ask God to bless you and keep you during this time. Father, we just thank you and we praise you for this opportunity, Lord, that you've given us today. Thank you, Lord, that you allowed us today just to come together today, Lord, to celebrate Sister Vernell Brewington today. Father, we thank you for her. Thank you for her life today, God. Thank you the inspiration that she's been to so many people. Now, Father, we ask a special blessing over her life today. Father, we pray you continue to bless her, keep your hand upon her, protect her, God, from harm, from danger, God, from sickness and disease. Anything, God, that will try to hinder her, Lord, we come against it in Jesus' name today. And Father, we speak blessings over this congregation of people today. We ask, God, that you would touch them today, Father, that you would draw us all closer to you, Father, that we might be more like you each and every day. Now, Father, we pray your blessings upon each and every one here today. Pray your blessings upon those that are suffering, those that are sick, those in the hospitals, round about us. Keep us safe, we pray. We love you. We thank you most of all today, God, that you gave your life that we could be saved from our sins. We could have forgiveness today, and we could have peace and joy that's unspeakable and full of glory today. Now, Father, we ask, Lord, that the love of God and the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the communion of the Holy Spirit would go with us each one today. We love you. We thank you now for this day. For it's in Jesus' name we pray, and the church says, amen.
Our church family, the message today was about giving, not looking to receive all the time. And this is what we're standing here for. We're blessed to be able to give. That's our blessings to you, that the Lord has laid it upon us, our hearts, to tell you that we want to become your friends. We want to become your brother and sisters. When you call in to the cards, we take these cards and we pray over them all week. You become my intercessory prayers, because all of us are in need of a blessing. And it is a blessing for you to watch us. It's going to be a blessing when you come and we embrace one another. And there's just so much joy that is there for us if we just reach out and let Him give.
I needed the ladies
for us in store. And I know, Brother Chris, you'll second that. Because I know that my Brother Chris has got a testimony. I know that my granddaughter has got a testimony. Because where there's breath, there's life. And she has went through some things that I'm sure that she's got a testimony that she might be faced with as well. But we want to go in prayer right now. Father, we thank you. We thank you for the message today. We pray that it reaches out to those that are maybe not in a situation that they can give. But Father, we can always receive if we look up and put our faith and trust in you, because the monetary value does not have a price on it. Because you give, and you give more abundantly. You supply our each and every need, Father. The biggest need that we need is that breath of life. We cannot breathe without you. Father, we just ask you to be with us until another appointed time. Touch those that have been watching on our church this morning. Touch them in a mighty way. Answer their prayers, Lord, as we are calling upon for those to be touched, Lord. Father, it's your grace and your mercy and blessings that we ask for today. In the name of Jesus, to our Almighty Father, the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings, we say thank you. Thank you, thank you, and God bless you until we meet again. Bye-bye.